What's up, guys? This is Mike Lewis, going to be casting another game from SECS, the Thursday edition. This is a round four game, I want to say. I don't know what happened to the team names, so I'm most likely going to forget that what team names these guys have, but the Radiant, I believe, are Pirates, and the Dire are Not So Sneaky. At least that's what they have in the brackets. But apparently, like, there's no teams up here, which is really weird, so I'm most likely just going to end up calling them Radiant and Dire, just because that's a lot easier for me. But anyway, yeah, there was a whole bunch of delay because of people having to patch the game. Like, I had to patch the game, and then everyone else had to patch the game, and then the team didn't want to be casted, but they didn't tell me, so... Oh, just a whole big thing. But we're finally in a game, and hopefully it will be one worth watching. The Radiant, well, the Dire, though, going to open up their draft with the Doom after banning the Silencer as well as the Lich. It's going to give some pretty powerful heroes to the Pirates side. They could go for Brewmaster, they could go for a Batrider, they could go for a Lycan. Even though they're Radiant, it's still a good hero, the Lycan. It's still worth picking up, I think. Or they could go for some Dubstep. Faceless Void as well as the Witch Doctor. So Faceless Void as the first pick. I mean, who would have thought we'd ever see the day, but this is the second time that that's happened, I think. I think first game had a Faceless Void first pick as well, although I could just be wrong. It's an interesting hero. I mean, having the Chronosphere is definitely a huge boon to any team fight, really at any stage of the game as well. And even without that, he could put some serious hurt on with the time lock. So yeah, TI4 is looking pretty good as far as the variability of the picks are concerned. But Faceless Void as well as the Witch Doctor got some hidden synergy in that regard. If you Chronosphere well, you could land a Maledict within the Chronosphere. And whoever you land that on is pretty much screwed. Like, you're not going to get out of a Maledict and a Chronosphere unless you have, like, obscene luck and or the enemies have a heart attack and forget to kill you. But then, of course, you could also Death Ward inside the Chronosphere. And that's a lot of pain, because really, Death Ward, it hurts no matter what. 60 damage doesn't seem like a lot, but it's a lot. I could assure you that it's a lot, especially since you're most likely going to get near a full channel if you're going to actually drop it in or around a Chronosphere. So a nice little combination for the Radiant side. The Dire, though, they're going to pick up a Doom as well as a Disruptor. Doom gets a little bit of variability from the in the lanes, and Disruptor is a pretty good counter versus Faceless Void. If you are quick on the draw, you could glimpse him back after he, ideally, after he time walks before or after he time walks after he Chronospheres, so that he has to walk all the way back. And well, even if that doesn't happen, being able to lay down a Static Storm in or around a Chronosphere is really going to make things difficult for the Radiant team to actually get that said Chronosphere Death Ward combination going. Disruptor and Doom might play together in a lane, but really Doom, for the most part, is going to be self-sufficient 9 times out of 10. Just the ability to put him in any lane is going to mean that the Dire are going to have a pretty large advantage moving forward in this draft. Some more strong bans kind of come out, Ember Spirit as well as Batrider Lycan, still in the pool, and I think it would be a mistake not to ban him or pick him, because he's really good. The Dire could definitely use him a lot more than the Radiance can already with the Faceless Void pickup. Adding a Lycan to that is a little bit awkward. Faceless Void and Lycan. Howl kind of is synergy, but that's about where the similarities, where the cooperation ends between the two heroes. Like, they both need farm, and you could lane the Lycan in the mid lane, and that could sometimes work. I mean, we've seen that a couple times recently. But it gets a little bit awkward, and I think that the Dire would definitely benefit a lot more. The problem is that they have Doom, who could also go into the safe lane, but Doom could easily solo a lane, then Lycan could go into a lane with two or three other heroes, or with one or two other heroes in a dual or tri-lane. But instead they're going to ban out the Tinker as well as the Weaver. I think between Faceless Void and Witch Doctor, they would have had more than enough to actually deal with the Weaver, but regardless, it is an annoying hero to deal with, especially when one of your support stuns is a very, very slow projectile in the Paralyzing Cask. You could just Shikuchi and be like halfway back to your tower by the time that projectile actually lands. If it does land at all, like, you'll have to dust while the projectile's in the air or something like that. So it's more of a getting rid of the annoying hero pickup. And I think with Faceless Void, they also could have dealt with the Tinker pretty well. But who knows? The heroes are out of the pool one way or another. And now, sitting on another 20 seconds, what do the Pirates want to pick up? Well, I mean, they need a whole other team. I mean, Phases Point and Witch Doctor are good, but you need somewhere else to go off of that. Viper is going to pick up, looking to just get strong lanes, I think. That's going to be their priority in this particular game. Viper, most of the time, will lock down a mid lane pretty hard, or at the very least, should not get demolished in the mid lane. There are some matchups that are better or worse Viper, but none where Viper is, like, going to get totally steamrolled. For now, it looks like the Dire, though, going to pick up the Ancient Apparition, so they will get the double supports up. The problem is that, well, Doom isn't that great with Chilling Touch, although, as far as carries go, he is okay, just because he's able to keep up with the target due to the Scorched Earth, and then actually make use of that extra damage. And, of course, Disruptor's range, so he's going to have that as well. Chilling Touch, not really going... No, not Chilling Touch. Cold Feet. It's going to be very difficult to actually land, so I think for the not-so-sneaky team, they're most likely just going to put their eggs into the Chilling Touch and Ice Vortex basket. And, ooh, we see a Treant and an instant Meepo pick. Okay. Well, that's, that'll play. That'll definitely play. Treant Protector will assure that Viper wins the lane. We saw, I think, Excalibur play Meepo a couple times in the mid lane. Against a Viper, I wouldn't really recommend it. It doesn't seem like a good matchup to me, but what do I know? I don't really play Meepo that much. But Treant Protector will allow the Vaseless Void to be very safe, especially if Witch Doctor decides to get, you know, 1 or 2 points in that Voodoo Restoration. It's all about the strong lanes for the Radiant, whereas the Dire, they're going pretty deep into this Meepo. It's always an X factor whenever you see a Meepo in a game, just because it's hard to evaluate how much work he'll actually be able to do. Centaur Ban, I think, very, very smart, as the Double Edge absolutely destroys Meepos. It makes it so hard to both micro and do anything at all. Also, Stampede is a pain in the ass, so that's also a thing. Now they have a setup for the Ancient Apparition Cold Feet, but I still don't think it's going to be a very high priority for them. Treant Protector, Witch Doctor is a pretty aggressive roaming combination. Not as much for the Ancient Apparition and Disruptor, especially since their lanes aren't able to contribute as much. Like Meepo, if AA and Disruptor come in, he'll be able to throw a net and then maybe poof, but the odds of that working perfectly is very slim. And ooh, a PA on their last. Well, I mean, if there's going to be Meepos on the field, a good way to deal with them is to just hit them with a 450% crit. Write that down, take that to the bank. So yeah, I'm interested to see how this Meepo is going to actually do this game. There's not a huge amount of AoE, but PA, Viper, and Faces Void, they're all just specialists in targeting and killing really hard, one thing. And that's what you have to do when you're Meepo. I mean, of course, if you could land a stun to stun all the Meepos, prevent them from moving around and everything like that, it's nice. But really, you just gotta focus down that one poor Meepo who's going to take the bullet for the rest of his Meepo squad. And PA, Viper, Faces Void are really good at doing that. And then, aside from that, they'll have the Overgrowth from the Treant and the Maledict as well, which ideally would land on more than one Meepo, but you know, even if it doesn't, Cask is going to be very annoying for the Meepo to deal with, unless his micro is extremely on point, which it should be. I think if you're in round 4 of this, then and you're going to pick up a Meepo, you should be pretty comfortable with how good you are able to micro that hero. But Shadow Shaman is going to be the last pick for the not-so-sneaky side. I'm inclined to think this is going to be their mid lane, but Meepo in the mid is always something that is a possibility. Not the strongest hero in the mid lane. Like, he could survive because of doing bottle antics. He does excel, I'd say, a little bit more on the Radiant side, just because he will be able, if he does jungle, or if he does go on the in the mid lane on the Radiant side, he'll have easy access to... Okay, we can't draw on the map when it's paused, I forgot. He'll have easy access to this camp as well as this camp, so he could stack that, pull that, and then poof it down later on. Dire, the walk is a little bit further to get to these camps. It's still a thing that Meepo can do, but it's definitely not as strong as if he's on the Radiance. So I'm inclined to think that the Meepo is, in fact, not going to be on the in the mid lane for the not-so-sneaky side. This is where the cards go on the table. I do not know who is the mid lane player for the not-so-sneaky side. I think I would put Lust there as the Shadow Shaman, but maybe I won't. I don't know. There's no good matchup in this mid lane. Like, no matter what you do, it's going to be difficult. It's either a Viper or a PA, and granted, Viper's a lot stronger than PA, but either way, I mean, Shadow Shaman does not have a good matchup versus the Viper. He is going to get pulled some tangos, so it looks like it will be Lust who's going to head towards the mid lane as the Shadow Shaman. Taking a look at the other lanes for the Dire side, we have IX Mike 88, going to be heading down towards the bottom lane as the Doombringer, looking to solo that lane all by himself. Leechy is going to be on the Meepo, supported by Fluff on his AA and Dismek on the Disruptor. Meantime, on the Radiant, we have Mr. Spike playing the support tree and protector, Phantom Assassin. Already picked up a poor man's shield, so she's going to be pretty durable. She's going to be played by Isaka Taiga. I don't know if that's supposed to be like one of those name puns or whatever, but ZZZ is going to be on the Faceless Void. Arg Pirate is going to be on Viper, and Hanging Sky is going to be on the Witch Doctor, looking for an early engagement. The cask, if it gets thrown, that could mean the death of something. The Tree Protector does have Boots, and he does have Leechy. Leechy is going to land, and Stifling Dagger is going to land as well. Fluff is in a lot of trouble. Time Walk, plus the cask. Fluff is going to get beaten down by the big old tree, but in the end, it's the Witch Doctor to draw first blood, killing off that Ancient Apparition. Normally, you don't see engagements like that actually working, but hey, Stifling Dagger is really long cast range, and having a tree with level 1 boots is exactly what I like to see. I mean, tree has so much potential in level 1, 2, 3 scenarios, because first of all, Leech Seed is a pretty ridiculous slow. 28% for 4.5 seconds is not bad at all, but it gets even better when you can beat down with 85 damage a pop. That kind of really helps a lot. So the Tree Protector, as well as the Witch Doctor, they're going to be looking to be very aggressive in this early stage of the game, whether it's in lane or going to the mid lane and trying to do that against Lust. Either way, it should be pretty good for them, because Lust is going to end up going toe-to-toe with the Phantom Assassin. This is not as bad of a matchup as Shadow Zone devices in a 1v2 lane. Fluff's an IX mic. Yeah, you don't want to be fighting that, Faceless Void. Stout Shield is good, but it's not that good. He's going to get dropped very, very low. That Chilling Touch getting so much value. Double damage or not, Faceless Void cannot stand up against that. Now Leechy might be in a little trouble. Cask can get thrown. Mr. Spike does have a Leech Seed, but that's the aggression I'm talking about. Just having Boots, being able to hit the Meepo, or hit anyone, just one or two more times with 85 base damage is no joke. It's the real deal up on that top lane. Top lane has got to be really careful, and well, the bad thing is that Meepo without farm is a very sad Meepo, and Meepo is going to get a little bit cornered. Mr. Spike is here to just lay down more beats on him. Meepo does have boots picked up really early, but he will be able to survive a little bit easier to that, but still he's being zoned out really, really heavily, and that's not a fun place to be as any hero, let alone a Meepo who is very, very reliant, at the very least, of getting that first point in Divider We Stand. Then, when he gets that, he could pseudo-jungle. It still won't be the best for him, but hey, it's better than nothing, right? But this tree is being perfectly aggressive, and that's exactly what I want to see. Taking a look at this mid lane now, 6-0 versus 8-0. Shadow Shaman getting a fairly easy matchup. I think he could count. He's counting his stars that it's not a Viper in this mid lane. Instead, Viper is going to be played as the one-position role for the Radiant team right now. He's just going to be farming up, but I really don't think the Viper's... There's a lot of wasted potential here for the Viper. PA could be doing this, and PA late game is a lot better than Viper late game. When you're picking a Viper, you really want to abuse the fact that he is going to win the lane most of the time. And when he's up here, I mean, yes, it's nice to have a Viper who's really farmed, but there's so much wasted potential. A lot like how if Treant did not get boots first, there would have been a lot of wasted potential. And what the wasted potential... I meant before when I said Shadow Shaman and PA shouldn't be able to kill each other, at least for a couple more levels. I meant level 6. Okay, that was my bad, guys, but shit, why did PA die to the Shadow Shaman? Mistakes were made, guys. Mistakes were made. My bad. First kill missed in tonight, actually. Maybe it's because Isaka was doing stuff like this. Maybe the courier was looking tasty, but either way, Phantom Assassin. She could do stuff like that to Lust pretty much all game long. Lust does have a bottle, find a regen rune, so Isaka is going to have to rely heavily on the dagger moving forward, but that's perfectly okay with the Phantom Assassin. Mr. Spike and Hanging Sky looking to roam around just a little bit. Witch Doctor level 2 has yet to pick up a skill at level 2, really just holding that skill point. Now ZZZ might be in a little bit of trouble. Don't sleep, bro! Time Walk level 2 is going to get him out, and chilling and the Living Armor will keep him up, but this Faceless Void is getting absolutely nothing on this bottom lane. He's 0-0. And 0-0-0. Leechy might be in a little trouble, though. Maledict is going to land. Cask bounces for a second time on him. The Leech Seed actually getting a cancel, but Leechy is going to dive, get dove really deep. The Maledict is going to be enough to kill him off, and now the Leech Seed is going to restore everyone up. They could very easily just get a kill on Dismek right here as well. Eat the way out, it's not going to happen, because Viper is right on your ass. Rest in peace, as Arg gets a double kill. In the meantime, bottom lane looks like the Faceless Void had a narrow brush with death, but he is going to play it a little bit. He's gonna play a little bit risky. What are you? Four man shield value. Fluff needs one more hit. Backtrack. Faceless Void. I don't know what you were doing, but that was a bad idea. Why did you do that? It makes no sense. He was praying for that 10%. But maybe he thought the Ancient Apparition didn't have boots? I don't really know what the thing was there. But topside, Arg Pirate is going to get netted down after being glimpsed. Leech is going to get a single poof off, and Arg Pirate should be going down here. Right click, not going to do enough with the Living Armor. Here comes the Faceless Void and the other two supports. So Dismek has got to be a little bit careful, but I think he should know about this. The other two supports have been gone for a very long time. And Dismek and Leechy, they're both going to get away just fine. But Living Armor showing its value. And Ix Mike is left to his own devices in the bottom lane. Doom with already boots, Ring of Basilius, Gloves of Haste, probably going to be a hand of Bidas. I mean, he's getting no pressure on him, like literally no pressure. So I don't see a reason why you shouldn't go for hand of Bidas in this scenario. Lust up on the top lane with an Invis rune has a ward trap possibility. There's the aggression onto Leechy and the Maledict as well. ZZ going to get caught with the net. There's the ward trap, but it's not going to actually trap anyone. Just do a lot of damage, Mr. Pike. In fact, it will do enough to bring him down. The other two Radiant Heroes are trapped in a very awkward position. Already used Time Walk. Faceless Void is luckily going to be ignored. Hanging Sky is definitely going to die right here unless you... Oh, no, don't do the Serpent Wards. That's not safe. Don't go over there. Okay, so that happened. Also, Faceless Void is going to escape. Use the Rewind tool. What the... I don't even know how to use the rewind tool, guys. Is that actually patched in? If anyone knows how to use the rewind tool, I don't actually know how to use it. I forgot that kind of existed. I will rewind if someone tells me how to rewind, but as of right now, I don't know how to do it. Isaka Taiga is going to go straight for Fluff. The Cold Feet might proc on him. It's going to be close. No, it will not. And now a big crit. Not too big. 170-something. It's respectable, I think. It's respectable as PA finds a solo kill versus the very, very soft, very fragile, because he's made of ice, Ancient Apparition. Haste Rune is going to... Okay, don't take the haste. Don't leave the Haste Rune for your PA. They're instead going to try to go for Ix Mike, who does have Doom. The cast is going to get thrown. Maledict, only level 1, and it missed. I don't know... You kind of maybe underestimated the cask stun, I guess. It wouldn't have made a difference, to be fair, but... The fact that it happened that definitely happened. But Dream Protector, looking to possibly make a dive going on to Dismek. Level 4 Disruptor will keep him safe from one of the targets because he'll be able to glimpse one back. The Faceless Void is now finally going to get a little bit of free space up on this top side. Viper is a lot more capable of at least fighting back versus a Doom, surviving versus a Doom AA. Is now going to be nigh impossible for any solo hero, but Lust, in the meantime, is going to get dropped very quickly. He's going to drop the Serpent Wards, do a little bit of damage to Hanging Sky, and it's not really going to matter all too much in the end. I mean, Isaka Taiga is going to also run through the Ward Gauntlet, but in the end, I mean, these Wards are just going to be a little bit of farming for the Shadow Shaman. Shadow Shaman getting dropped. That's actually his first time, but bottom lane is where the aggression is really going to happen, as Arg Pirate... He's going to get dove after getting doomed up, but two teleportations, Ix Mike and Fluff, they have to watch out. They may or may not get this Viper, but they're definitely going to pay for it one way or another. Time Walk, the jump forward from the PA, and the Ancient Apparition is already dead. Now Ix Mike, I think, is just completely trapped. There's no escape. Two men enter, one man leave. Chain Protector gets one kill. Ancient Apparition dies to the Radiant, so kind of a balanced kill there. But either way, a 2-for-1 trade. Diving that Viper, as soon as they saw the two TPs, they just thought YOLO, but YOLO is not always the best strategy, guys. Write that down. That deserves to go into my book. YOLO? That should be the title of my book. YOLO is not always the best strategy. A book by Mike Loris. Isaka Taiga, though. Roaming a lot more than PAs normally do, but he's the... You need to spec on Dota TV... Not broadcaster. Oh, okay. There we go, Lego Pirate. Cannot rewind. I'm sorry, guys. Although, I should be able to rewind. Right? I mean, spectator, broadcaster. I don't know. Oh, maybe it's because then they won't have anything to see. Yeah, you're transmitting to no one. That makes sense. Leechy cutting it a little bit close with his Meepo jungling, but he is holding on to 1,700 gold. Is he going to upgrade his boots? Is he going to rush an Aghanim Scepter? Is it just going to be a Blink Dagger? Either way, this Meepo is getting a little bit of a more decent, early mid-game than the initial laning phase is concerned. The face is Void up on top, kind of mirroring that Meepo situation. They're both still in a little bit of trouble, especially this face is Void, as there is two supports coming in, or two rotations coming in. Chronosphere is going to get dropped on Lychee, but ZZ, you bit off way more than you could chew. Doom onto the face is Void. Can they kill off this Meepo? Level 1 Maledict? Maybe level 2 Maledict. This is level 2, so that will be enough to kill off Lychee. Or will it? Lychee's going to survive. He's tangoing up, and Hanging Sky also getting chased down by IX Mike, as well as Dismek. The connect field, and Hanging Sky is so dead. Chop him with the big sword. He's dead. Here comes the Sakataga. Big crits and the kill. He's going to get jumped back, not all the way to his fountain. The glimpse did not bring him back that far. Is he now going to try to go for IX Mike? Doesn't have that much mana. Doesn't have that much damage. I mean, Treads is just not an end. Ooh, okay. Tree and Protector getting sniped by the Ancient Apparition. Isaka Taiga really just going to go hard on that Doombringer. In the end, not really going to be able to finish the deal. Pant Assassin doesn't really need a whole lot of gold and funds and stuff to do a lot of damage. Level 2 crit certainly is going to help. But if you want to get kills on the PA versus a Doom, you need to be, packing 4 points in Phantom Strike. You got to be able to stick the target for the long haul. This build, I think, is definitely the smart move for the mid lane if you want to focus on survivability, but it just means you can't kill the Doombringer solo, which, take that for what it's worth. Sometimes it'll be relevant, sometimes it will not. Mid lane, let's take a look at Lust. He has used Serpent Wards once again. I believe that was on the bot lane engagement that I missed while I was watching up top. But either way, these Serpent Wards have been dropped 2-3 times, and they have yet to take a Tier 1 tower. When you have a Shadow Shaman, you want every single usage of that ultimate to equal a tower, or Roshan, or any big objective, let's say. And dropping them for a kill or two is sometimes nice, but he's only 2-on-1, and he's only used Serpent Wards for one of those, or two of them on the top lane. Regardless, it's going to be a mid lane push for the Radiant team. Ancient Apparition's ultimate is going to land onto only one. You're going to get the chilling effect on the second, though. Isaka Taiga is going to fall back, but Arg Pirate's going to try to go for Dismek. Static Storm is there, but the connect field does not latch him in time. Glimpsing him back with the Doom, Arg Pirate is so screwed right now. Here comes a big poof. No, it's not going to happen. The Overgrowth is going to return the favor, and the Chronosphere going to catch Lychee as well as Lust. The Dubstep not going to be enough. He gets shocked down. The poof damage now coming through. Isaka Taiga gets a Dominating Streak. Will try to go after Fluff. The mischance. Run, mischance. Oh, Lychee blinks forward for one more right click, but it's Fluff in the end who gets the kill. Chronosphere being used, but unfortunately there's actually no follow-up in that when you're all netted to the ground. So, I mean, as far as team fights go, the team with the Phantom Assassin and the Faceless Void probably should not be the ones pushing the issue, but, Viper did get caught in the end to start that off, so you really can't fault too much. I don't really know what Pirate's doing right now. It's probably a bad idea. He's going to get glimpsed back right into a connect field. No, connect field once again is going to miss. Here comes the Faceless Void. Does not have a Chronosphere, but they will get the Viper Strike up onto IX Mike. Fluff is going to kill the Tree and Protector in the meantime, but IX Mike will go down, so it's a 1-for-1 trade. Tower is going to be destroyed as well. Arg Pirate continue to farm up these wards. A 1-for-1 trade. But they also get the tower, so I think the not-so-sneaky side are going to be completely okay with that. The first tower of the game, and it's going to give Meepo a little bit more in the way of his funding system. 1,200 gold is up on him, so we get a point booster, go for his Aghanims if he does want to do so. If not, picking up the upgraded boots seems like a good plan, but it's going to be the point booster, looks like this. Tier 1 traded for the Tier 1 fortifications there, Dismek. With 4 glimpse, 1 kinetic field, 1 static storm, not the best in a brawl, this disruptor, but tower won't be happening, won't be denied rather. ZZ going to get shattered, most likely. He's going to time walk right into the Ancient Apparition ultimate. Now the glimpse back onto Arg Pirate. He's going to get hexed up immediately and shocked down. Hanging Sky is going to get out, as is the Phantom Assassin. They get the tower, but at the cost of 2 heroes. I really think the Radiant team, what they have to do right now is just chill out. Just slow it down. You have a Phantom Assassin, you have a Faceless Void. Yes, Meepo is a very powerful hero, but Phantom Assassin, once you get a BKB, you could just insta-give him, like literally 100-0. But the Blink Dagger on Lust means that stuff like this is going to happen. Shock has already happened. Kinetic Field with the Thunder Strike. Spike is not taking that much damage. He might survive from this. In fact, he will survive from this. Unless Glimpse... right click shock. He's gonna get the leech seed out on the Shadow Shaman. Now here comes ZZZ. He's gonna get hexed up. Isaka Taiga is also here. Lust is so screwed right now. Doom though onto Hanging Sky, and Chronosphere is there too, but ZZ cannot get in because of the kinetic field. Ancient Apparition Ultimate is gonna come in. Hanging Sky getting saved just a little bit by armor, but that's not gonna happen. Tree's gonna drop as well. ZZ on the way out, as is Isaka Taiga. And Leech is going to blink forward. The glimpse back, though, it's on cooldown. And ZZ, oh, he didn't jump far enough. No! Run! It's hopeless, ZZZ. You need another time walk. Refresh. Dash refresh. Oh, it's unfortunate for him. They get the Shadow Shaman at the cost of 3 Radiant. You just got to chill out, guys. Stop picking these fights. The enemy team has 3 Blink Daggers. Yeah, that's 3 Blink Daggers with a glimpse. It may seem like you're taking a good fight, Radiant team. Pirates. But when the enemy is able to reinforce that easily with the likes of Blink Daggers plus the Ancient Apparition Ultimate, which, by the way, is almost Aghanimmed. Like, it might actually be Aghanimmed before the level 2 Ice Blast, which I've actually never seen before. The only time I've seen that is an Aghanimmed Scepter being picked up before level 2 Ultimate is with Tiny, and that was someone doing it intentionally because it looks crazy. But they're going to try to defend this top lane. Mr. Spike going to get Hexed and the Shackles up on Vasus Void. The Chilling Touch is there, and the Ancient Apparition Ultimate might shatter him. No, the Living Armor will keep him alive for now. The Serpent Wards will continue to work on this tower. The Shatter Effect will not happen. Can they get this tower denied? They will deny, but here comes Leechy. He's in a lot of trouble, but Lust is going to jump in as well. The Overgrowth is going to catch absolutely everything. Arc Pirate going to try to focus down Leechy. They will be able to bring down one, but can they take anyone else? The cast going to bounce only onto heroes. Perfect value, but doesn't matter because the tree is already dead. The Death Ward is going to get dropped, but instantly it drops it due to a glimpse. ZZ just going to go to the death. Here comes the Phantom Assassin. Going to try to go for the Shadow Shaman. They will bring him down. Now Fluff trying to hide in the corner, has a TP scroll, will get stunned up, will get killed, dropping an unstoppable streak. PA is going to cash in on that fight. 1500, 1600 gold on this PA, well on her way to her Battle Fury, and somehow, someway, the Faceless Void lived. I mean, Faceless Void has jack all for items. He has Mask of Madness possibly shipping out to him. Yes, he has Mask of Madness now, but he's just relying on the bashes, relying on that 10% backtrack to keep himself alive. And hey, it worked. Mission accomplished, guys. Mission freaking accomplished. All the while, Mr. Spike actually has the same score as the Faceless Void. Just look at that. Making sure that he keeps his allies alive. That was a pretty good overgrowth, stopping the Meepo perfectly in his track so that Isaka Taiga is able to actually get in there and do some damage. The Phantom Assassin in the mid lane, you want him to be contributing as much as possible, and well, I mean, he has been contributing. He's been involved in 10 kills out of the 15 that the Radiant have found themselves with. But now they're up against a Roshaning team. With the Serpent Wards in the pit, they could take a fight in theory if they had Chronosphere and Death Ward up and were nearby. But yeah, the Leech is actually taking quite a beating from this Roshan. The Serpent Ward is not doing enough. Ix Mike, get in there and tank. I mean, they have a Vlad's, but Lifesteal on Meepo is kind of negligible because his base damage is so low, or his attack damage is so low. So Roshan will die. Aegis goes to the Meep. And Leechy getting fake critted. You don't know how that the illusions will say a number, but that red number will get the illusion minus damage then applied to it. So if it says 400, it's not actually 400. It's 400 times illusion rune damage, which is 33%, I think. So, whatever number that is, it's still a lot of damage, sometimes. So PA going to continue her way onto that Battle Fury build. Take a quick look at all the other items that we are going to be seeing in this game. Faceless Void, as I mentioned before, with the Mask of Madness. Tree Protector with nothing. Hanging Sky is going to go the way of the Ancient Apparition, who has hit Aghanimmed Scepter before level 2 Ice Blast, so that's pretty cool. But he's going to rush up the Aghanimmed Scepter, get a lot of boosts in his Death Ward, but I don't know how long he could actually rely on that Death Ward being channeled. The Chronosphere is going to be huge in that, but we haven't seen that so far. If he gets a full channel, or a lot of channel, like 6-7 seconds, or hell, even 5 seconds, 4 seconds, that's fine. He just needs a little bit more time to channel it. Then the Aghanimmed Scepter gets really good, otherwise it's a little bit disappointing, because it just gives you health. Phantom Assassin, yeah, she's doing her thing. Arg Pirate does have a mech up and available. And I don't actually think there's a mech. No, there's no mech just yet on the Dire. I don't think at this point they're even going to go for one. Doombringer is going to rush in Shiva's most likely after picking up that Vlad's. Blink Dagger, now a hand of Midas on Lust. That's a late Midas. Kind of uncharacteristic, but whatever. Meepo still working his way towards that Aghanim's, and now Doom onto Faceless Void with level death on top of that. Instantly, between the chilling effect and the Doom, he's going to get dropped very low. I don't think you'll be able to save him from this one. Can you deny him through the Shatter? It'll take guts. It'll take balls. It won't happen, though, because when you're dropped that low with an Aghanim Scepter Ice Blast, it is going to be a death sentence a lot. Yeah, so this Ancient Apparition, he's been getting lots of kills, and that only means more kills moving forward. Leechy might get stunned by Hanging Sag, gonna throw the cast. Going to be in any danger, because the enemy team, the Radiant team, is not gonna push the issue. Instead, Isaka Taiga is going to clear out a 1, 2, 3, 4 stack of Ancients, not too terrible. Gonna do so pretty easily as well, not taking too much damage. That's this blur really making it easy for the Phantom Assassin to tank hits from those Ancients. 15 to 21 at the moment, and the Dire are in a pretty nice lead. But I do like that the Radiant have just slowed down their game. They're no longer looking to be super, super aggressive all the time. Instead, just going to be satisfied with taking farm where they could get it. Now, they will have to worry about this Ancient Apparition Ice Blast, which is going to be very, very dangerous. Especially if they do get any lifesteal moving forward. I mean, Voodoo Restoration is going to be a non-factor just because you can't heal. So there's that. And mech is going to be the same scenario as well. So the Radiant are going to slow down. The Dire are going to accept that fact and just get a little bit more farm onto Leechy. He's not the most farmed hero on the map. He's, you know, doing decent as far as net worth is concerned. Fourth place. Not exactly where you want to be as Meepo. You really want to be on top, but his Aghanim Scepter is well on its way. He's only 300 gold away from that, and it looks like there might be some aggression on this bottom lane, especially if this Ancient Apparition Ice Blast hits, and it will. Kinetic Field, Static Storm onto ZZ. He's going to get shocked down and brought down. Serpent Wards now deployed, and the Glimpse back onto Arc Pirate. Is there any disable? There's the Ice Vortex, but it's not going to be enough to lock down this Viper. I don't really think they care, though, because they are just going to go for this Tier 2 tower. Hanging Sky. Yeah, dropping some wards for easy free damage in the tower. When the enemy team farms them all up, it's not the best scenario, but hey, damage is damage. Especially when the other team has a different game plan altogether. Because right now, the Radiant, they don't really want to force huge fights. They're going to fortify based off of the mid lane Arc Pirate in a little bit of trouble. Here comes Lust with the double damage rune. Has a Hex, has a Shackle, and is going to get Viper Struck for his troubles. Lust, though, going to pop the Ghost Scepter, get a Hex out to Isaka Taiga, and the Ancient Apparition. Going to land what I believe to be a lethal dose of ice on this Viper. He might survive. It's going to be close. Keep an eye on that. Because the armor is actually going to go on to PA. Blink forward from IX Mike. Going to get a Doom onto ZZZ and try to kill him off. But the entire team is there. ZZZ going to get restored up because of Hanging Sky. And they will keep him alive for now. Doom, will it be enough? With Lust jumping in, it most certainly will not. Overgrowth now on Lust. And he's going to be dropped one way or another. There we go. Isaka Tiger will try to go for Dismech. Just barely short of that kill, but they will maybe chase him down. Stifling Dagger has absurdly long range. Unfortunately, the Radiant don't really have great ward coverage. Dismech needs one more hit. He will TP away. Everyone else is going to be just fine on this bottom lane. Greedy kill. IX Mike going in way before the rest of his team is even close to helping out. And the Blink Dagger, Ghost Scepter, Shadow Shaman, who is, by the way, very, very farmed. Being able to help out in some regard. Disruptor just barely escaping with his life, who's also going for an Aghanim Scepter, by the way. That's the fourth Aghanim Scepter we're going to be seeing. Probably the third. Meepo has one. We have Ancient Apparition. And then Disruptor. Shadow Shaman probably not going to go for one. Neither is Doom, and Witch Doctor is very, very far away from that. Aghanim Scepter not even going to be attempted on Void, I don't think. He's instead, yeah, just going to go for Power Treads. They know that Leechy's here. Well, this is awkward. Arc Pirate's like, do I fight or do I run? Chronosphere, kill him. Kill the meeps. Beat him down. Ancient Apparition Ice Blast, come in. Leechy's gonna poof. No, not gonna poof. Yeah, well, when you're stuck in the trees like that, you have to stay in the trees, and then you die. And now on the back of that Meebo kill, they're going to try to take a tier 2 tower. Let's deal with an Ancient Apparition Ice Blast. Now it's level 2, so it does that much more damage. They should be able to take down this tier 1 tower without that much of an issue. It's below 600 HP, so they don't really need the tree here. They don't really need the Witch Doctor here. Yeah, the damage that they have should be sufficient. Dream Protector's going to do a little bit of scouting. Let's take a quick True Sight check. So far, I see none. There is absolutely none, actually. It's going to be a Tier 1 for a Tier 2, however. Serpent Ward, Round 2, and Isaka Taiga. I don't really know if you want to be teleporting into that. Doesn't seem like a good idea. He's going to reconsider. So lose a Tier 2 tower, but they get something. The Radiant, they're slowing down their game, but the gold earned from the Dire and experience is slowly accelerating out of control due to not one, but two hands of Midas, plus Devour on the Doom. So there's a lot of ramp moving for the Dire, and of course Meepo is able to farm at an accelerated pace just because it's Meepo. So they're going to slowly start to fall behind, and then they're going to have to rely on the late game, late game potential of their heroes. When you're talking about PA, when you're talking about Chronosphere, that's definitely a possibility. However, ZZZ has not had the best game of his life. He's 1-8-7. He's fairly broke for a carry hero. And by fairly broke, I mean he's not getting Jack. Arg Pirate? Well, I mean, IX Mike, they see you. But you have a Blink Dagger, so how quick are you? Jump in, and the Chronosphere. IX Mike is going to get bashed down. Maledict? No Maledict because of the kinetic field. ZZ is going to drop first. Isaka Taiga is going to jump right in, but it's a little bit too late. IX Mike is already on the run. Stifling Dagger needs another Phantom Strike. Big crit to finish him off. Where's the rest of the fight? Arg Pirate is doomed up. He's going to get the living armor on him, but he's going to die one way or another. Lust and Fluff now. Going to get chain stunned due to that paralyzing cast. Fluff is going to drop, and he's going to get punched down by the tree, and Dismek is the only one to survive. Meepo. Don't know where Meepo was. Meepo was like, screw you guys. I have other things to do. It's a 2-for-3 trade, and Faceless Void taking the brunt of that assault. I mean, that's the best way that they have to initiate. If you're going to throw a Stifling Dagger, that's probably not it. You have to Phantom Struck him to actually be sure that you're going to get him. Or have a Faceless Void jump in. Anything else is just going to result in IX Mike blinking away. So there was no great solution there, but Phantom Assassin coming in and collecting some heads. It's a good situation for this PA to be in. BKB Battle Fury, 26 minutes into the game, has some pretty fast farm, and now with that level 3 coup de grace, is going to be able to farm up an absolute storm. Plus, cut down a Doombringer. Like, you can't underestimate that fact. Doombringer now has 20 armor. I think he had Shivas. Yeah, he had Shivas before that fight, so that was a 20 armor Doom. 22 armor, rather. Doom that Isaka Taiga just dropped a 900 crit on. Like, that's no joke. That's serious business right there. So this PA, if the Radiant could keep this PA safe, and if they could keep the PA uncontrolled by CC, then they will be able to get a lot of value out of these crits. But if Meepo is on the PA, if the Doom dooms the PA, or if Shadow Shaman gets his hands on her, it's going to be a little bit of a rough time for her. Because right now this PA is, the biggest threat that the Radiant have. So they have to make sure that they actually get value out of this threat. They're going to smoke up, and they're probably going to run into the Ancient Apparition. Ancient Apparition is so screwed right now, although Lust is here to get a Hex onto Isaka Taiga. Jump forward for ZZ. Going to get a Chronosphere onto 2. Big crit going to kill off that Ancient Apparition. Isaka Taiga, though, is going to stay in the Static Storm, and he's going to get doomed and brought down. War Trap now onto Mr. Spike, who will get the Overgrowth off. ZZ going to try to kill off Dismek, but he's not even powerful enough to do so. Mr. Moore is going to bring him down. Lust going to get dropped due to Poison. Hanging Sky and Mr. Spike still somehow alive. I don't know how, but it's going to be a 2-for-2 as it stands right now. Where is the Meepo? I don't know. Dismek and IX Mike both chain stunned because of the paralyzing cast. The Viper doing so much damage to that Nether Toxin. The Meepos are coming in, but they're going to get disrupted by Isaka Taiga. And Viper still trying to pick a fight with IX Mike. The PA is going to kill off the Meepo, and IX Mike is spotted. Does not have a Blink Dagger. He's going to try to fight his way out, but the big 1k crit from Isaka Taiga, plus the Voodoo Restoration from the Witch Doctor, keeping everyone alive. Ancient Apparition responds. Sniper mode engaged. Lock on. That was hella close, guys. Holy shit. Okay. So that's the value that I was talking about with PA. Meepo was a little bit late to the party, and that costed the Dire severely. Like, Meepo just got pretty much 1v1'd by PA. Battle Fury makes it a little bit difficult to micro, and of course, I'm pretty sure the level 19 PA is going to be able to kill the Meepo at this point. She's going to go for, I want to say, a Basher next, But it really doesn't matter because she's bringing down people really well. As long as his Faceless Void gets a little bit of farm, you know, an item here or there is going to be fine. His Chronosphere is mostly just a device to set up this now Aghanim Scepter Death Ward. So, quick Aghanim Scepter check. This might be the most I've seen. One, almost two, three, four, five. Once we hit six, I'm pretty sure it will be the most Aghanim Scepters I've seen in the game. In a game I've casted. I don't know about my own games. I don't really keep track of that kind of stuff. But looks like both teams know that Roshan is up. Radiant team, they smell potential right here. Ancient Apparition Ice Blast is going to be a little bit hard to use when everyone is in such tight quarters, but the Chilling Touch is still there. Arc Pirate's going to get netted down first and foremost. And Jump Forward from Ix Might going to get a Doom onto the Phantom Assassin. Phantom Assassin doesn't really have that many options right now, and Arc Pirate's going to take a lot of damage. Hanging Sky also going to get shocked down pretty low. Mr. Spike needs his Overgrowth, but it's not going to happen. He's going to get brought down. Death Ward up on the high ground, doing less than nothing. Arc Pirate is still going to go 1v4, taking so much damage, so many hits. Finally, he does go down. Everyone else has got to back off. Isaka Taiga is now back off of that Doom. Going to try to go for him, but the Ancient Apparition Ultimate, oh, it's going to connect. That's a death sentence. No, he has BKB. Not quite. BKB and fight it out? No, shock and die. Lost with the triple kill. That's four down for the Radiant and a free Roshan. That positioning is just so very awkward. There's not many good places to drop a Chronosphere when the enemies are coming from both this direction and this direction. And with Serpent Wards acting as another tower over here, I wish you could draw a little bit easier on the water. There's no good Chronosphere. I mean, you had two heroes here, you had a couple of heroes back here. Chronosphere here after the PA backed off would have been the best bet, but Viper was over here. So, you know, one way or another, Viper was going down. The hell? That was weird. So, kind of a mediocre positioning to take that fight from the Radiant side, but at the same time, there's nothing that you could really do about that. Arg Pirate's going to be so pissed off about this. Like, do I keep going? He has a mech. Tough decisions to be made when you get hit with an Aghanimmed Ancient Apparition Ice Blast right out of the gates. But it's 26 to 32. And PA, if she's able to do that damage, then she'll be fine. But really, once she gets doomed, you can't really do that much. You could try to fight it out. I think that realistically, she could kill the Doombringer before the Doombringer kills her. But that doesn't really cross your mind, because first of all, you have to deal with Blinking Meepos, Blinking Shadow Shamans, and Ancient Apparition Ice Blasts, and Glimpses, all that unfortunate stuff, which, by the way, is now Aghanim Scepter, the Static Storm. So it's not really going to cross her mind. So she's not going to do that anytime soon. Ancient Apparition Ice Blasts, kaboom skis. So annoying, guys. It's so annoying. You have no idea. You probably do have an idea, actually. I don't have to tell you guys. You guys know. By Isaka Taiga. He doesn't have any item progression just yet. Still dropping those 1k crits. Four figures of crits is pretty nice. Still hovering at that 1400 gold area. I think that's because the PA was forced to buy back in that previous fight in this area down here. Looks like they're going to gear up for smoke. Not spotted by the enemy team. But it's kind of an obvious smoke. Like, it's a semi-obvious smoke. They're just going to go for it. But so you can see everyone from the Dire, they're backing off. Backing off very securely, actually. They might run into some Meepos. We're going Meepo hunting. And Paralyzing Cast is going to get so much value. Oh, they found one! This poor Meepo is so screwed. Yeah, you're dead. But only Aegis dead. Where's the real one? All the way over here. Does he respawn over here? Nope, they all respawn over here. And Meepo walks away. Easy game, easy life. Now, that would be really unfortunate if they found the main Meepo. But fortunately for them, that didn't happen. And meanwhile, bottom lane, just a easy Serpent Ward drop from the now Aghanim Scepter Shadow Shaman. These Serpent Wards do some really heavy damage once they get that Aghanim Scepter, and they might be enough to just focus down this tower, at least put it down into deny range. Lust is still here. Ancient Apparition Ice Blast is going to come through. As is Ix Mike's Doom. Shiva's Guard going to bring down both supports right away. Isaka Taiga is going to teleport in, going to get some big crits. Chronosphere can happen only onto Lust, however. Ix Mike is going to carefully walk around. They want this kill on this Doom, but can they get him? It's so difficult to kill a Doom with this much armor. Now ZZ going to get hexed up. Shackles? No, just a shock is there. Isaka Taiga, he's going to be the one to get shackled. Arc Pirate is going to get the Aghanim Scepter right after he uses Viper Strike, unfortunately. Isaka Taiga going to get poofed down. He's going to get brought down. Does he have a buyback? He does have a buyback. He needs to use it right now because his base is in full breach. He doesn't have a BKB, though, and that means he can't fight this. If he gets netted down once, he's screwed. Leechy is going to go to town on this melee Rax. He's going to go to town on the Ranger Rax, and then everyone is going to back the hell off because there's nothing else to do right now. Go towards the mid lane, take a free tier 2, or try to solo kill the PA. Yeah, Static Storm actually doesn't do that much damage. It does do a lot of damage, holy crap. Oh no, that was because Frostbite was also applying damage. I'm always kind of disappointed at how much the Static Storm damage does. It's always seems like it should be doing more. But they get a free set of Raxes on the bottom lane, the Dire side. And the Radiant kind of caught without their full force at the same time. I mean, having your tree and Witch Doctor drop before they can even think about dropping their ultimates, not an ideal situation for any team, really. And another quick Aghanim check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Aghanims. Six Aghanims. Definitely setting some new Aghanim records here, guys. Easy. The Dire are slowly constricting the Radiant space. The fact that this face is void has had not a single item pickup for like 10-15 minutes is really hurting their cause. And Isaka Taiga hasn't had any item progression either because he's been forced to buy back. Fluff has been able to afford a Ghost Scepter. It's going to save him for a little bit. I don't know how long it's really going to save him. The Hex is there, plus the Nets. Fluff is going to throw out the Ancient Apparition Ice Blast. It'll only apply the Chilling Effect, and he will go down in the end. Ancient Apparition down. Is that enough to actually make a go on anything? Can I take a Tier 2 tower off of this? I don't think they can. The frost effect is bringing them down, and bottom lane is in full breach, so someone's got to deal with that. And can they take a 4v4? I don't think so. The Radiant are just simply too weak at this point. IX Mike going to see a very tasty target, perhaps. Shiva's has two Dooms available with that Refresher Orb. He's going to get hit with the Cask as well as the Maledict. The Doom is instantly going to castle that Death Ward. ZZ looking for the Chronosphere. Will get silenced, though. Looking for it again. Looking for it once more. Gonna catch Dizmek, but Isaka Taiga is getting beaten down by all these little meepos. Isaka Taiga will go down. Meantime, ZZ hexed up. He's unable to kill his target in the Chronosphere. The poofs are going to annihilate the tree, and Elichi is gonna try to run away from this one. Still, the Faceless Void is trying to hunt down this Disruptor, but I don't even think he could get it. This Disruptor is so tanky at this point. He's level 15, same as the Faceless Void. Has a glimpse, has a kinetic field, and here comes Elichi with the hex with poof damage. There you go. Get him a body bag, because that Faceless Void is really, really dead. In the meantime, Lust can try to go toe-to-toe with Hanging Sky. That's not going to happen, but if that Ancient Apparition Ice Blast hit, it might have happened. But the Tier 2 Tower will go down in the end. Regen Rune, because that's always fair. And Lust has his Aghanim Sceptered with Refresher Orb. Wards, he already used one back here to have a gem on the floor, but yeah, this Tier 3 tower is going to drop, and unfortunately, I think only three of these wards are in range of the melee racks, so these are going to all focus the range racks, but I don't really think it matters. Oh, five are in range. Look at that. I don't really think it matters, because these things are going to drop regardless. Now, Hanging Sky going to get caught in a kinetic field. Lust has a Hex, has a Shackle. Don't really want to use it on a Witch Doctor who's, you know, frosted to the floor anyway, but that healing is doing some real work for that Witch Doctor, and Arc Pirate gonna teleport in, gonna drop a Viper Strike onto Fluff. Mr. Spike is gonna jump forward for an Overgrowth, which will land on Fluff, but there's no damage. There's damage finally. Fluff's gonna go down, but Leechy is here and he's pissed. The net from Hanging Sky will not hit. The Death Ward doing a little bit of damage. Here comes ZZZ. Doesn't have a Chronosphere, so he's probably just going to die as well. I really don't know what the plan was here. I could tell you there was probably no plan. Net is going to fly, miss on Hanging Sky, but the right click damage plus the shocks is enough. PA is back in this game, but you're missing a base. Kind of short one base PA. So bottom lane, gone. Mid lane, gone. Top lane, next on the list. Tier 2 tower is very, very easy to take at this point. And I think at this point, the Dire might just be too far ahead. 30k gold advantage, upwards of 25k experience. The team fight, the item progression from the Radiant just has not happened. 13 deaths on the Faceless Void. The Faceless Void, the only thing he is right now is a Chronosphere. Like, aside from that, he could not do anything else. And that's a really sad situation. PA, without any item progression of her own, starting to fall behind as well with this Meepo, with the Sheepstick, with a point booster? Scotty? More slows, more fun? And try to go for Isaka Taiga. Gonna get the hex off and all the poof damage. Beat down. That's a free kill for Leechy. And now, well, IX Mike going to take down this tier 2 tower on top side. As I said before, a very easy tower to take down at this point in the game. And the fact that it's below 300 HP is kind of helping as well. The last order of business is this last set of Raxes, and IX Mike gonna get, well, Chronosphere catches absolutely nothing, literally nothing. IX Mike, though, gonna get Maledicted, the Death Ward can do enough to bring him down eventually. IX Mike is gonna go down, but doesn't matter, because here comes Leech from behind. Arg Pirate is going to get beaten down, the poof damage, there it is. Dismex dropping pretty low, that Ghost Scepter really not helping him with that Viper Strike. But still, only the Witch Doctor survives, and he doesn't have a Death Ward. There is no chance in hell for the Radiant anymore. Good game has been called by Mr. Spike, and it looks like, okay, well, the Raxes were being brought down, but so was the Ancient. So that's going to be it, guys. Don't really know who I'm going to be casting next, but there are still more games to be had. If you enjoyed the cast, then be sure to follow the channel and stick around for the next game. GG.